Explosions in space are so astronomical that there is no way that we can't observe it. But what if we find ones that are so massive yet so elusive to our eyes? Let's find out how mergers from neutron stars and black holes could hide from us. Ever since we learned to look up and become amazed with the nighttime, humankind has been observing the celestial sphere, finding new things to fuel up the level of being impressed that we already have. And we definitely have come a long way from the days of the early Arabic astronomers squinting their eyes hard to make out something from their star maps, to devising the very first telescope, to building huge instruments that can measure gravitational waves. It has been a really long way for us in terms of observing the night sky. Having all of this firepower, it's practically impossible for anything to miss our sight, right? Well, if the universe is that easy, then we would have nothing more interesting to learn. Of course, there are things that are beyond our observational capacity. This day, however, we would like to talk about two of the most powerful, most extreme, and most hardcore objects we have seen in the universe: neutron stars and black holes. These two are so hardcore that they are practically zombies of dead stars. I know what you're thinking, that's kind of an awkward analogy, but bear with me. I'll explain how that's the case. So we have known for a long time that, just like us here on Earth, stars also undergo a certain life cycle. They start from a cloud of particles, which then accrete and coalesce to form a baby star, which then eats and eats more particles to grow into a giant star. And when it's large enough, gravity takes over and collapses it, and then it explodes. Then it leaves behind a new product. For stars with average mass, the final product is a white dwarf, a star that is about the size of the Earth, but is about as massive as the Sun. You can't imagine the amount of density on that one, but believe me when I say that's nothing to what we'll talk about later. Now, if the star grows up to be extremely massive compared to the average, it fuses hydrogen and helium at a super fast rate. More fusion translates to more energy. So when the gravity finally takes over and collapses the star, a supernova so bright that it outshines the whole galaxy takes place. From that point, one of two scenarios can happen. Firstly, the atoms in the star can collapse so tightly that it effectively eliminates the spaces between subatomic particles, squeezes the protons and neutrons in it to form neutrons. When the compression resolves to a sphere with a radius of 10 kilometers, we get the densest physical object in the universe, the neutron star. It was even believed that this object is so dense, a part of it about the size of a sugar cube would weigh about the same as all of humanity. All of it in a bite-sized sugar cube. Don't lie. I know you thought neutron stars were a group of neutrons that clustered together to form a star, didn't you? Although you somehow hit a point. Since neutron stars are composed exclusively of neutrons, you can't imagine it to be a gigantic atom. And then we have another scenario. Sometimes the gravitational collapse can be so strong that it compresses the star to a volume so infinitesimally small that you can practically say there is no volume at all. At this point, a black hole is born, a region in space where the gravitational force is so enormous it practically bends the time and space around it by a huge magnitude. How severe is this force? Well, let's say that even light cannot escape it and eventually gets eaten by it. Everything that gets close enough just gets consumed by it. So I hope at this point you see how the zombie analogy from earlier works. Isn't it fun? But there's where it gets more interesting. Just as when two zombies meeting one another can cause a lot of chaos, so does when pairs of neutron stars and black holes. Let's explore first what happens when two neutron stars are close to one another. Do you have an inkling on what would happen? Let us know in the comment section below. We discussed earlier how neutron stars are the densest objects in the universe. And that being that, it tells us that they exert a great amount of gravitational force as well. Now imagine what happens when two of those come close to one another. As they approach a certain distance, the two neutron stars will begin to rotate about a common center of gravity. As time goes by, the gravitational force becomes stronger and stronger, and the two stars begin to spiral towards one another, until finally they merge into either a large neutron star or a black hole, depending on what scientists call the Tolman-Oppenheimer-Volkoff limit, We won't dig deep into that, as this is completely another topic, but let's just say it's some kind of threshold measurement. This merger results in a huge outburst of energy, and it's just not in one form. As Einstein's theory of general relativity predicts, objects with gravitational force as strong as neutron stars are bound to distort the fabric of space-time. This distortion in the fabric of reality is measurable through quantities which we call gravitational radiation of gravitational waves. Besides that, another product that results from a neutron star merger is electromagnetic radiation, in the form of light and gamma radiation, which we call the kilonovae. What's so special about this is that scientists have long been puzzled about where heavy elements come from. And one hypothesis they formed is that they could have been from neutron stars, but it hasn't been verified through observation until the first merger of neutron stars were observed. I can only imagine how ecstatic the scientists were when they finally achieved this verification. Okay, so we've covered one type of gigantic merger. Now we move on to the next, the merger of one black hole to another. After emerging from the corpse of two highly massive binary stars, like the scenario where we had the two neutron stars, they will spin around a common barycenter until they finally come close to one another. Now, we have mentioned earlier that a black hole's favorite activity is to practically just devour anything that comes near enough, remember? Well, this is exactly what happens when two black holes reach a certain distance. They consume one another until they merge into something that we call a supermassive black hole. A black hole having a mass tens to hundreds of billions of our suns. Just imagine the amount of gravitational force on that one. And as objects have extremely large gravitational forces, they cause ripples in the space-time, which we detect here on Earth through our GW, gravitational wave, observatories. It's easy to think that this is a once-in-a-lifetime event, but apparently if we look up GRACE-DB, the reports database for the LIGO Observatory, we would see that collisions like this happen as often as once per week. Thank goodness we aren't positioned near one, right? All of humanity and all we have ever known will be gone faster than the blink of an eye. So at this point, it's easy to figure out what we are going to talk about next. We have covered mergers between two neutron stars and two black holes. How about a merger between a neutron star and a black hole? This event is of huge interest to the astro community, as this will shed light about a lot of things. For instance, the black hole will most probably shred the neutron star to pieces. So it would shed light to what exactly do we expect to see inside it. Speaking of shedding light, are we going to expect a huge burst of light or radiation when this happens? All of these will finally be answered upon a verified observation. And then just last year in August, the LIGO and Virgo detected an event which may finally give the answers the astronomers have long been looking for. Gravitational waves were detected from event S190814BV, reading with a very high mass gap. And scientists inferred that this couldn't be anything but a black hole neutron star merger. So at that point, have we finally done it? Have we detected a merger between a neutron star and a black hole? Well, it's almost a yes. Detecting gravitational waves is a great tool for detecting massive events. But of course, our ingenuity doesn't let us settle with just one measuring tool. We've also set up a countermeasure to verify our observations. Massive events such as neutron star black hole mergers must emit some kind of electromagnetic signature, whether through X-rays or light or other related quantities. This is the primary task of the electromagnetic counterparts of gravitational wave sources at the Very Large Telescope in GRAVE, spearheaded by the ESO, or the European Southern Observatory. The twist in this story is, despite the GW observatories celebrating with the controversial amount of gravitational wave from event S19081BV, InGrave, on the other hand, failed to detect any electromagnetic counterpart of the event, which is why, as awesome as it could have been, we're still yet to discover a neutron star black hole merger. But scientists did not lose hope over this. They stated that it could be possible that the event was simply too overwhelming for it to leave any trace. They think that what could have happened is that the gravitational force from the black hole effectively just swallowed the neutron star entirely, without even disintegrating it. This might be the reason why there weren't any traces of electromagnetic counterparts to support the findings. But this is still yet to be proven. Let that fact sink in, though how a black hole could get so massive that it wouldn't even leave a trace of what it consumed. Now that's one scary zombie. Just this year, scientists released additional information with regards to finding black hole and neutron star mergers, stating that besides being difficult to detect, they could also be hiding from us inside dense star clusters. Trying to be sneaky, aren't we? When we say dense star clusters, we are talking about a group of stars that are collected together. On average, a star cluster can contain up to just 0.4 stars per cubic parsec, but in dense ones, it could get as crazy as 100 to 1,000 per cubic parsec. That's an extremely huge margin. With the definition, it's easy to understand how a neutron star and a black hole merging can hide easily. A dense star group implies a very intense electromagnetic signal source, so any reading that will be done in this place can be easily mistaken for noise. Moreover, due to the number of stars in these types of groups, it is also impossible to pinpoint a gravitational wave source at this point. Now, okay, why not look anywhere else for the merger that we intended to find? Well, one thing we haven't pointed out earlier is that the mergers that we have already observed are from the corpses of the binary stars, even event S190814BV. We are yet to observe a dynamically interacting black hole and neutron star, that is a black hole paired with another star meeting a neutron star paired with another star. Scientists thought that the best place to find this is inside a star group, where almost all scenarios of stellar collisions might most likely take place, which is in dense clusters. Think of it this way. If we are looking to find a pet cat, would we go to a liquor store? Of course, there's the possibility of finding a stray cat to take home, but if you want to be able to choose what breed of cat you want, how fat you want it to be, or whether you want a boy cat or a girl cat, your best option is a pet store. In the same analogy, a lot of cosmic scenarios are available in a dense star cluster, so we would understand why astronomers are focusing a lot of energy in searching these star groups. But all hope is not gone, as there are new expeditions being launched into space to study exactly how stars in dense clusters behave. In 2034, European Space Agency's Laser Interferometer Space Antenna, LISA, mission is scheduled to launch, and scientists believe that this would give us a better understanding of stellar behavior in dense star clusters, which could finally bring us closer to finally seeing a neutron star black hole merger in this type of group. It's a long way into the future, but until we come to that, we are continuing to search for verifiable mergers between neutron stars and black holes in places where there's less noise. I don't know about you, but I feel like every day we become closer to that goal. That's what I think, but I want to know what you think. Do you think S190814BV is actually a black hole merging with a neutron star? Or do you think it's something else? Let us know what you think in the comment section down below. Answering to your questions and queries is something that we take quite seriously.